Nikki opens the door and they wheel into the garage. Nikki is good at opening the door on the run, it is not easy, you must push the button 3 times 2 seconds apart with a tolerance of 1/4 of a second, it is a triple frequency system, both of the girls have a button on their bike. This garage has all of the camping gear in it, for their bikes there are little chambers in the wall, they have their own second sequence code, no bike is visible in the garage. The whole family has their own bike, Charlotte is counting Nikki in. She considers Nikki part of the family, when Nikki rides hers home she parks it in her bedroom. Charlotte's father purchased all 7 at the same time, it was one of the major disasters of her family's peaceful coexistence, they are $3,000 bikes, her father never paid that, the $16,000 for the works he did pay put her father in the position of an aggressor by her mother's assessment. Her mother declared war, about 6 months later she signed the truce. There are 2 other garages besides the one they have for their bikes and camping gear. The first story of the home is below grade on 3 sides. Upstairs over the bike and camping gear garage there is an office, and library. Charlotte's mother or Jane has never used the library. Jane prefers to use her own bedroom for studying, Charlotte thinks Jane just fears irritating their mother by doing otherwise, it may be she would be too close to Charlotte for their mother's comfort. You go find Jane, I will stop off at the library office and call my mother, then I will be along later, I will not be long. A little later Charlotte is knocking on Jane's door. Who is it? It is Charlotte. Come on in, it is not locked. Charlotte slowly opens the door letting herself in, Jane is sitting back in her recliner reading a book. Charlotte walks over and sits in the other recliner that faces Jane. Beside the recliner in which Jane sits, is a large deluxe desk and office chair, a 2-drawer file is to the left of the desk, Jane closes her book laying it on her desk. It has been who knows how long since Charlotte has been in Jane's room. Charlotte knew Jane had the largest bedroom in the house but she did not realize it was so large. It is much larger than their mother's or their father's bedrooms, their parents have separate bedrooms. Your room is great Jane, I could learn things from you. Thank you Tyke, I do not cope with disorder very well. It is embarrassing, I did not realize you were so neat. Charlotte stares at Jane, she is so much like their mother. You are so beautiful and I look so unlike you and mom, I should belong to another family, I lost out on any of the beauty in the family. Tyke, don't say things like that, you are cute, very cute, and everyone thinks you are. You just look more like dad, everyone thinks he is very handsome. I thought you would be deep in the wilderness by now. We are going to Trout Lake with friends of Nikki's tomorrow, it is really a beautiful trail, 2 years ago Dad took Nikki and me over there, some of it overlooks Trout Lake. Jane turns sad and depressed. What is wrong, Jane, did I say something to upset you? Sort of, it is okay, it is me and my own problems. Things that you would rather I didn't know. Oh no. Truly I would like you to know, I don't want to bug you, I shouldn't be crying on my little sister's shoulder. Age has no meaning in a good relationship, I really care about you Jane, it hurts me when you are unhappy, I have hurt for mom, too, I know she cannot be happy with our family so divided, but I know nothing to do about it. You wouldn't mind hearing some of my problems then. Do speak, I would like to make you happy if I can. Since you were 3 years old I have felt left out, you being so close to dad has always hurt me, you are so busy with your life you don't realize I exist, you never need me. This is the first time in the last year that you have been in my room, you have never sat down until tonight to chat. Charlotte realizes she should not sit there listening to all of this without letting Jane know how she feels. You are right Jane. It has worried me very much in the last few months, I have been hurting for you, I have not known what to do about it, the way Mom is, I didn't know if you wanted a close relationship with me, Mom didn't want us getting very close, I would have liked you to be in the special experimental class, I thought you would not consider it because of Mom, you have carried a huge load for Mom, if I tried to get close to you, I was afraid it would just give you more problems with Mom. I was not about to make it any worse for you. I understand, Tyke, it would have given me more problems, it truly is not your fault, you are right, back then I could never have gone against what Mom wanted, Mom has had full control of me, but not anymore, I do not care what Mom thinks, I will not live life the way she sees it, I want to be close to you and Dad, my past has been miserable, Mom will have to come with me if she wants to be with me, I will not live by her appraisal, I am not going to be alienated from my own father and my sweet little sister any longer. I am very sorry, Jane, I will try to be a more caring and loving little sister, I really do need you. It is so unfair, I do all the things that interest me while you dance around on Mom's puppet strings, I would be so happy if you could do all of the things that interest you as I do. Tears trickle down Jane's face, Jane is soon out of her chair, she scoops Charlotte up in her arms as if she were a little child, she sits down in the recliner in which Charlotte was sitting with Charlotte in her lap. Neither of them speaks for a while, they just hug and cry. Don't doubt that I need you very much, Jane. I love you so much, Tyke. She kisses Charlotte on the cheek. Jane lays Charlotte back on her arm, resting it on the arm of her chair so she can see Charlotte's face. This takes me back to when you were a little Tyke just after you learned to walk well, perhaps you were between 1.5 to 2 years old. I enjoyed you so much until you were about 3, I spent many wonderful hours with you, I don't remember Mom spending any time with you. At 3 Dad stole you away, he took you everywhere he went, I had to go with Mom, the church and the ministry was her thing, then is when I really started hurting. I complained, she says, I know how you feel, your father is mixed up, and he treats Sasha like his son instead of a daughter. Do you know any of what I am telling you? No, I appreciate you telling me, I understand our family better, a family should not be so distant. You are right, Tyke, I don't know how to deal with Mom, I think Dad is very concerned about her. Am I getting heavy? Not at all, I doubt you weigh 100 pounds, you are so solid, I should not be surprised knowing the active life you live. I am close to 100. I work out with Nikki twice a week. I have always been jealous of you being so close with Nikki, it is like you two are blood sisters. Would it be okay to use your bathroom? Of course it is, you have no need to ask my permission. I will go with you, I need to rinse my face with some cold water. That sounds great, I would not mind that myself. Jane has a nice bathroom adjacent to her room as Charlotte does. The vanity looks to be 12 feet long with double sinks instead of 6 feet like Charlotte's does. The room is enormous, 3 times, the size of Charlotte's. Their father must have expected Jane to do her aerobics nude. For what else would you need such a large bathroom? Their father did not skimp on bathrooms, there are a total of 7 in the house, all 5 bedrooms have private bathrooms. Jane rinses her face and by the time Charlotte is ready to rinse her face, Jane sits yoga style on the carpeted portion of the floor. Do you have problems with your stomach anymore? I have heard rumors that you were healed a while back at a revival. I don't know, Tyke, Mom thinks so, she doesn't know what I have been doing for my problems, for the last 2 months, I have been eating much like you, Beth and Barney have helped me keep it a secret, when I am here at home, Beth sees that I have everything that is good for me. I did not change my diet to help my problems, I just wanted to experiment since you were so healthy, you can see, I don't know why I have no more problems. It was little Sarah that motivated me, she has pushed me to get closer to you, she hurts with us being so distant. Mom is very upset with little Sarah eating as you do, she says it makes her a privileged character, she says Sarah feels she is better than the other kids are, I know that is not true. Maybe she is in some ways, Charlotte says with a mischievous smile. You don't see it as Mom does, she thinks my poor diet is the cause of my being so scrawny. You are not scrawny, small, but you are not scrawny. I really don't know what to think, Tyke, my problem did not change until I changed my diet, I even drink that awful tasting wheatgrass juice, of course, it really does not taste so awful. Wheatgrass juice may not taste so good to some. Dad started me on it when I was very young, I know it to be no different from some other beverages that I drink. It depends on how you grow it though, in my travel around the country, I have tasted some that tasted bad, Barney's grass tastes the finest, you may have been healed at the revival, to know for sure is not that vital as the whole of creation is a miracle. Tyke, we are so unaware of each other's lives, it is sad. Do you think Dad and I should not have secrets? I see no reason to think it to be wrong to have secrets. I would not care if you knew many of my secrets if I knew it would stop there, I would rather publish it in the newspaper than to let Mom know, at least, it would be true not twisted when it hit the public's ears, you know how Mom is, Jane. How many times have you heard, now Linda, we can do without the latest gossip about the church and neighbors, we all have things more important to occupy our minds. Then Mom starts in on Dad, and I end up just walking out on her, it makes me feel awful, I would leave before Dad did, I would go to my room to cry, sometimes, Dad would come to comfort me later. I felt awful too, Tyke, but I did not have an escape like you and Dad would leave and Mom would start crying and hugging me, I did not want to see her hurt, she had no one. Don't take me wrong though, I see things differently now, I am not sure that I helped Mom by staying, I was not strong enough to do anything else. Dad and I have a lot of secrets but not because we want to hurt you and Mom, we have not had a choice, I have hurt because of it, if only Mom could understand others' needs. Dad had secrets before he married Mom. You mean Dad had other lovers or been married before? Oh no. It is nothing like that, Dad is very loyal and honest, he loves Mom very much. Does Mom know you read all those psychology books? No, but I am thinking of letting her know. Why, are you going to tell Mom you do not want to work in the ministry? Too, I have heard you tell her you wanted to be a therapist more than once, did she hear you? No. And she just took opportunity to tell you what she had planned for your life. I was thinking of telling her about not wanting to work in the ministry, also, I must be honest with Mom about everything, I would feel that I was getting my life together. Don't talk to Mom without Dad being there, she will run over you with her plans for your life like a bulldozer demolishing a house, it will be a taste of hell picking up the pieces. You are right. Dad will be there and so will you, I like your spunk, Tyke. Being with you makes me feel much stronger, I have known for quite a while, I would eventually have to choose between Mom and Dad, a child should not be forced to do that though. It is not between Mom and Dad, Jane, do not be foolish. Not really, it has felt that way, though, it is between what Mom wants and what makes me happy, that may not be true. Either, Mom has sown doubt in my mind referring to Dad as an infidel, an enemy of God, his sin was taking you to hell with him. She would have had Dad ousted of his position long ago if she could have, but there would be no school without Dad's certification, she worries about her finances, it has dwindled. Jane's back is against the wall, she sits yoga style, hands are lying in her lap. She stares at the carpet in front of her as she relates her thoughts about Mom to her little sister, Charlotte's back is to the vanity, she is struggling to keep from going up in flames, she is so miserable. Jane looks up into her little sister's face and turns pale with fright.